teach. Damien's going to come and just...
Good morning, everyone. My name's Damien, for those of you who I've never had the privilege of meeting. I'm the pastor of Hope Church. Before we go on to the next thing, there is a blue Nissan in the car park out the back. The window is open and the alarm keeps going off. So if that's your car, this is your walk of shame. We have the privilege this morning of dedicating a young lady. Her name is Aria Rose, and so I'm going to invite Alex and Chantal to come up, if they're here. There they are. And let's welcome them as they come. So these guys, you may not recognize their faces. They are actually from London, so they're posh. yeah, they're from London. They are. Their family lives in Corby, and they've been to the church a number of sometimes to visit. So they're currently looking for a church, but they feel like Hope Church has become their home. So they've asked if they could dedicate their daughter with us this morning. So what a huge privilege. So I'm going to just read some words out, just to let you know what we do in this church. We don't baptize babies in Hope Church. That's what some churches do. We believe baptism is something different. I'll explain that in a moment. But dedication is where two parents who love the Lord recognize their child as a gift from God and want to give thanks, almost give their child back to the Lord, and just pray for God's grace to be godly parents. So that's what we're going to do this morning. So I've got some words that I'm going to read, some promises that the parents are going to make, and then the parents are going to pray to dedicate Aria Rose to the Lord. and then we're going to invite some people to come up and just pray blessing over them as a family. So I've taken the words of Psalm 139, which is a very famous psalm, very beautiful psalm, and I've personalized it for Aria Rose. So listen to this. Father, you created Aria Rose's inmost being. You knit her together in her mother's womb. She is fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. Aria Rose's frame was not hidden from you when she was made in the secret place. When she was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw her unformed body. All the days ordained for her were written in your book before one of them came to pass. So this child that you hold in your arms today, she is a gift to you from God. She is loved, beloved by the Father. And in this church, we don't baptize infants, as I said. We value baptism highly. We believe that the Bible clearly instructs believers to be baptized, but that means that a person comes to faith first and is then baptized. And it's our hope that one day Aria Rose will come to know the Lord for herself, and she will follow the Lord through the waters of baptism. But today is something different. Today is an opportunity to thank God for a precious gift of life, and it's a sacred moment where you share with your friends, your family, those who you love, and you stand before God and you ask for his grace and wisdom to raise her as her parents. So we're told in 1 Samuel chapter 1 that Hannah dedicated her son Samuel to the Lord. In Luke chapter 2, we see that Mary and Joseph brought their baby Jesus and dedicated him to the Lord. And in the same way today, Alex, Chantal, you're going to present Aria Rose to dedicate her to the Lord. So, as you love the Lord, and as your hearts are filled with his love, and as you speak about Jesus in your home, and as you demonstrate your love for him in the way you live your lives in front of Aria Rose, our prayer is that she will know his love for herself and respond to his gracious invitation to become her, his child and follow him for herself. So I ask you these questions in the presence of the Lord and in the presence of his people. Do you today recognize Aria Rose as a gift from your loving Heavenly Father and give thanks for her life. And do you pledge as parents that you will bring up Aria Rose in the ways of the Lord, making every effort with God's help to sow the word of God into her life and to model the character of Christ to her and to love her unconditionally through all the seasons of her life? And do you pledge with God's help to provide for Aria Rose's physical, emotional, and spiritual needs? Look into your own Heavenly Father for help to do this. You do. And do you now dedicate Aria Rose to the Lord who gave her to you, surrendering all worldly claims upon her life and praying that one day she will come to know and follow Jesus for herself? Great. God bless you. So now, this is the moment of dedication. It's where you as parents pray to dedicate her to the Lord. So are you both going to pray, or one of you?
Okay, let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we come here today dedicating Aria Rose back to you, I pray, Jehovah, that you will help us to give us the knowledge and the wisdom to help her to grow in the way of your will and according to your ways. I pray, Jehovah, that you'll give us the strength to feed her spiritual food daily. Amen. So she may grow up to know you for herself and one day come back and dedicate her life through baptism to you. I thank you, Jehovah, that you have blessed us with this special gift. And I thank you for Aria Rose. Thank you for our family. Thank you for Pastor Damon and the congregation. I pray, God, that you may give the pastor and the congregation continual counsel so they can help us and other people to come and draw closer to you. All this I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Wow, what a wonderful prayer. God bless you guys. We want to pray for you. I wonder if Scott and Charlene, if you come up, and are there any family visiting today who are Christians who would like to come and pray as well? You're very welcome. The whole line, yeah. All of you. If you're looking for a more comfortable seat, now's your chance. Okay, and if there are any elders still in the room, I know some of them may be setting up for kids and youth work, but if there are any elders in the room, if you could come to the front as well, that'd be great. And so, yeah, just gather around them, just begin to pray blessing on their lives, and I'll pass the microphone to one or two people and we can just bless them as a family.
Lord Jesus, we just want to give you thanks this morning, Lord God. Lord, we thank you that you have blessed Aria this morning, Lord Jesus, that you have blessed us as a family with her. We pray this morning that, Lord, the guidance that she needs through us, Lord, you may help us in her words, in her attitude, in her thoughts. I pray that as a family, we will show her love and your love, Lord Jesus. We pray that when she walks, Lord God, you will go before her. We pray that you may cover her, Lord Jesus, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet, Lord Jesus. Not just today, Lord God, but for the rest of her life, Lord God. That in everything that she does, Lord Jesus, she will trust you, Lord. I pray that as a family, we will start now, Lord God, to embed who you are, Lord Jesus, and who you say she is in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God, we thank you for Aria Rose and my granddaughter and great-grand. Thank you today, Lord, that she can be baptized. Father, we give her the blessing. We pray to comfort each and every one of the father and the mother. Oh, God, provide for them in a special way. Take over their life, Lord, as they go by. Father God, I give you thanks for each and every my family. Oh, God, my daughter, my granddaughter, and great-grand. And, Father, I give you for my pastor. Father God, bless each and every one today. We give this message, and we pray for each and every one in this church to comfort and give God their life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lord, I just thank you for this example in front of us right now of your blessing from generation to generation to generation to generation. Lord, we just thank you for this example, and we just pray your further blessing, Lord, on little Aria Rose. And Lord, we just, it's so glad and so good to be able to just say thank you for all you've provided. Thank you, Lord, for the provision of children and grandchildren and now great-grandchildren, Lord, who will worship you, who will adore you, who will gladly just proclaim you, Lord. And we just look forward to seeing and hearing all that you do through little Aria Rose and through the rest of her family as you continue to bless them and you continue to use them to proclaim your name to this world for your glory and for your kingdom. Amen.
Our Father God, I thank you so much for Aria Rose. And I just pray that even all the way through her life, she will know who she is in you, Lord God. I pray that she will know that she doesn't have to fit in, that she will know that she is set apart and she will stand out for you, Lord God. I pray that she would just not look to the left or to the right, but she would focus on you, Lord God. And I just pray that you would, even now, that you would just be birthing something in her that is just going to flourish in something beautiful, that she will stand up and she will be an example of what godly woman, and even through her teenage years, Lord God, that what godly teenagers will look like, Lord. So I just pray that you would just mold that into her life, Lord God. And I pray that even the mindset, that she would have your mindset, Lord God, and that she would just grow up to be a godly warrior in you, Lord God. And I just pray that you would just pour out your love and grace in her in ways that she couldn't even deem possible, Lord God. And the people around her, I pray she'll be a seeker after your presence and she would seek your face, Lord God. So I pray that she'll be a woman of prayer, woman of worship, and a woman that would just love to be in the secret place, spending time with you, and that she would be a lover of your word and a teacher of your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Father, we give you thanks for Aria Rose this morning. Thank you for this privilege, Lord, that we are here gathered together. I pray, God, that you may bless her this morning, Lord, now and forever. And I ask for your guidance in their little family. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Should we show them our love and appreciation?